Walt, please. Let's both of us stop trying to justify this whole thing and admit you're in danger.
Who are you talking to right now? Who is it you think you see? You clearly don't know who you're talking to, so let me clue you in. I am not in danger, Skyler. I am the danger. A guy opens his door and gets shot, and you think that of me? No. I am the one who knocks.
I am the one who knocks. This iconic line, uttered by Walter White in episode 6 of Breaking Bad's fourth season, is a cultural phenomenon and one of the most quoted lines of television ever by this point. It's extremely badass, and the way that Walt reframes Skyler's fears of someone knocking on their door and shooting him to clue her into the amount of influence and power he now has is immensely impressive in its execution. And as a result, it's incredibly iconic and commanding. But the thing is, it's at best an embellishment from Walt, and at worst, it's a downright lie. Sure, there may be a time in the show, essentially during the first act of season 5, where Walt did indeed have that sort of threat and power and influence, where the name of Heisenberg caused others to back down in fear and look on in complete awe. But that had not happened yet. At this point in the story, while Walt had indeed killed people, grown in stature, become far more cutthroat and pragmatic, and done some insane things, the truth of the matter was that he was in the midst of losing his only partner. He was under Gus's thumb, and he had only not been disposed of because he was the sole person who could cook for him. He was pinned down at this point, with seemingly nowhere to go and nothing to do except keep quiet and do his job. Or else. And the title of the episode where this line is uttered tells the whole story about Walt in this moment of time. Cornered. The aura of badassery and power surrounding this line is incredibly ironic because at this point in the story, Walt is a far cry from the one who knocks when he tells Skyler this. So if it's not a genuine show of power, what actually is it? Well, it's the same thing that Walter White has been doing this entire time. It's a method of massaging his ego and making himself feel bigger.
I know what it could do to this family, but if it's the only real choice we have, if it's either that or you getting shot when you open your front door,
don't want to hear about the
you're
police.
Not some hardened criminal, Walt. You are in over your head.
No.
That's what we tell them. That's the truth.
No, it's not the truth.
Of course it is.
That's not the truth. The retort here is so childish that it's almost unbelievable that it's being uttered by a 50-year-old man. Now, of course, Walt ultimately ended up getting out of this through some malevolent yet brilliant planning and manipulation, but at this point, Skyler was very much in the right. He was in danger, he was in over his head, and this had indeed gotten too big for him. The only reason he wasn't killed was because he was able to put together some intricate plans to escape by the absolute skin of his teeth, but he was millimeters from biting the bullet. Him saying this is not a genuine display of control. It's the desperate front put on by a man who is close to denial and pissed off at his wife for framing him as vulnerable. Of course, he's absolutely correct when he says that if he were to stop going into work, a superpower of a business would go belly up and implode. He is essential to Gus's operation, without a doubt. But where exactly is the correlation between his job being so important and him being this hardened, terrifying man who knocks? He had never done anything like that, and the flashes where we see glimpses of this sort of thing from Walt are so far removed in context from what he's talking about. The brilliance of this scene is not that it establishes an aura of power around Walt, but that it is so clearly a very feeble attempt to establish that aura of power, with the spark being him getting angry for being looked down upon, just like always. Many things about Walter change throughout the series, but the core of who he is, the catalyst to his dark progression, has never wavered. That pride. he completely changed as a person, but that was only because he abandoned his fear and responded to that side of himself in a manner completely different than what he had been doing for the previous 50 years. He had awoken, but rather than that core changing, it was more like he decided to gather the conviction to actually do something about it thanks to his diagnosis, which led to this transformation. However, I don't mean to say that these words are insignificant for Walter's progress, because they do indicate a huge turning point.
That moment was very, very important because I think, at least for me, that was when you saw Walt's total transformation and a very specific statement on what he had become.
Yeah.
Did it feel that? Is that how you approached it?
Yeah. It was a transitional period for him where we saw remnants. There is never a switch going from Walter White to Heisenberg. There was never a pulling down a lever. It was gradual. It was losing Walt and gaining some of Heisenberg, and then it switches. And at some point, there's almost like, you know, your DNA. There's some DNA that's stronger than others, and I started gaining more and more of Heisenberg and less of Walt until there may not be any recognition of Walt at a certain point.
While Heisenberg had been growing and growing in prominence, Walt had never really said anything this outwardly threatening and scary before, and had previously expressed sadness at having reached too many points of no return, particularly in Fly. This line is the first time where he properly jumps into everything that persona means, and so this may very well be where Walter fully embraces the Heisenberg personality and dismisses his reservations completely in the wake of just having had enough of being told that he wasn't in control. But it all rings much more hollow when you realize that there isn't really much substance behind the words, and that is key to where his character goes from here. In spite of this gradual yet definitive evolution, after all this time, he's still that same small man with an inferiority complex trying to prove himself after feeling emasculated by his wife. And I think that deep down, he knows this better than anyone. As such, rather than being the truth, these words are much more of a rallying cry for Walter to get himself up and take the final step to become the person he says he is, to become the one who knocks. Rather than an accurate summation of who he was in that moment, this was something of a self-fulfilling prophecy and a preview of where he would be at the peak of his powers. Before everything came crashing down, and he ultimately realized that this all just got a bit too big for him. It's a brilliant subversion and one of the very best lines in the series, though not for the reasons you'd initially assume. Here, Walter issues a challenge of sorts to himself, with the end goal being becoming the one who knocks. But the tricky thing about goals like this, so dependent on grabbing hold of this sort of influence, is that once you achieve them, where do you go from there? Is it really possible to have your power lust satiated once you get there? And if not, what becomes of a man with this black hole in his heart that consumes everything? As subtextually genius as it is iconic and striking, I Am the One Who Knocks deserves every bit of acclaim it's earned for how beautifully it paints a picture of Walter White. Many thanks for watching.